हाय, दिस इज प्रियंका. यू आर वाचिंग इट सिंपल. ये वीडियो क्लास 11 साइकोलॉजी के लिए है और इस वीडियो में हम इंपॉर्टेंट डिफरेंसेस डिस्कस करेंगे फ्रॉम चैप्टर 1 टू चैप्टर 9. ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. तो फर्स्ट चैप्टर में सबसे पहला डिफरेंस है साइकोलॉजिस्ट वर्सेस साइकियाट्रिस्ट के बीच. साइकोलॉजिस्ट में हम लिख सकते हैं कि अ साइकोलॉजिस्ट इज समवन हु पोजेसेस द नॉलेज ऑफ साइकोलॉजी एंड होल्ड्स रिकॉग्नाइज्ड डिग्री इन द फील्ड. दे वर्क इन डाइवर्स एरियाज लाइक टीचिंग, काउंसलिंग, कम्युनिटी एंड एक्सेट्रा. वर्सेस जो साइकियाट्रिस्ट होते हैं, दे आर क्वालिफाइड मेडिकल प्रैक्टिशनर्स हु आर कंसर्न विद साइकोलॉजिकल वेलबींग ऑफ इंडिविजुअल्स. एक और तरीके का डिफरेंस आ सकता है, जैसे कि क्लिनिकल साइकोलॉजिस्ट वर्सेस साइकियाट्रिस्ट. ये दोनों भी बहुत ज्यादा डिफरेंट होते हैं. कैसे? सबसे पहला डिफरेंस तो इन दोनों की क्वालिफिकेशन होती है. जो क्लिनिकल साइकोलॉजिस्ट होते हैं, दे कैन नॉट एडमिनिस्टर और प्रिस्क्राइब ड्रग्स. वेयर एज जो साइकियाट्रिस्ट होते हैं, दे आर मेडिकल प्रोफेशनल्स एंड आर ट्रेन्ड इन एडमिनिस्ट्रिंग मेडिसिन या फिर ड्रग्स टू ट्रीट मेंटल डिसऑर्डर्स. ओके, नेक्स्ट डिफरेंस के बारे में बात करते हैं, जो है काउंसलर वर्सेस क्लिनिकल साइकोलॉजिस्ट के बीच. काउंसलर में हम लिख सकते हैं काउंसलिंग साइकोलॉजिस्ट वर्क विद पर्सन हु सफर फ्रॉम मोटिवेशनल एंड इमोशनल प्रॉब्लम्स वर्सेस क्लिनिकल साइकोलॉजिस्ट स्पेशलाइज इन हेल्पिंग क्लाइंट्स विद बिहेवियरल प्रॉब्लम्स बाय प्रोवाइडिंग थेरेपी फॉर वेरियस मेंटल डिसऑर्डर्स एंड एंग्जाइटी, फियर और स्ट्रेस. काउंसलर के दूसरे पॉइंट में हम लिख सकते हैं कि काउंसलिंग साइकोलॉजिस्ट मे बी इन्वॉल्व इन वोकेशनल रिहैबिलिटेशन प्रोग्राम्स और हेल्पिंग पीपल इन मेकिंग प्रोफेशनल चॉइसेस और इन एडजस्टिंग टू न्यू एंड डिफिकल्ट सिचुएशंस ऑफ लाइफ. वेयर एज जो क्लिनिकल साइकोलॉजिस्ट होते हैं, दे मे बी इन्वॉल्व इन कंडक्टिंग इंटरव्यूज एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रिंग साइकोलॉजिकल टेस्ट टू डायग्नोस क्लाइंट्स प्रॉब्लम एंड यूज साइकोलॉजिकल मेथड्स फॉर देयर ट्रीटमेंट एंड रिहैबिलिटेशन. राइट, नेक्स्ट पॉइंट काउंसलर में हम लिख सकते हैं कि काउंसलिंग साइकोलॉजिस्ट वर्क फॉर पब्लिक एजेंसीज सच एज मेंटल हेल्थ सेंटर्स, हॉस्पिटल्स, स्कूल्स, कॉलेजेस एंड यूनिवर्सिटीज. वर्सेस क्लिनिकल साइकोलॉजिस्ट में हम लिख सकते हैं, दे वर्क आइदर एज प्राइवेट प्रैक्टिशनर्स और एट द हॉस्पिटल्स, मेंटल इंस्टीट्यूशंस और विद सोशल एजेंसीज. ओके, जो नेक्स्ट डिफरेंस है वो है बिटवीन माइंड वर्सेस ब्रेन. देखो, जो ब्रेन होता है ना, ब्रेन इज बायोलॉजिकली इवॉल्व्ड ऑर्गन Concerned with complex functioning of human being. जैसे कि for example क्या दे सकते हैं, brain performs functions like basic body functions and survival, motivation and emotions, higher mental processes including language, planning, problem solving and reasoning. On the other hand, अगर हम mind के बारे में बात करें तो mind is a concept and unique to every individual having varying experiences. It is a set of individual sensation, perceptions, memories, thoughts, dreams, motives and feelings and emotions. Okay? Next difference जो आया था वो था between basic versus applied psychology. तो basic में हम लिख सकते हैं कि psychologists work in the basic areas like teaching and research, biological basis of behavior, the process of sensation and perception, learning and memory, cognition, human development, emotion, personality, social behavior, ethnic and gender identity and sexual orientation. Versus जो applied psychology होती है, it puts the basic knowledge of psychology in helping people and applying theories in day-to-day life. They specialize in applied fields such as client treatment, personal or marital counseling, industrial or educational applications or health psychology. अब देखते हैं चैप्टर 2 के डिफरेंसेस. पहला डिफरेंस है एक्सपेरिमेंटल वर्सेस कंट्रोल ग्रुप. एक्सपेरिमेंटल में हम लिख सकते हैं कि द सब्जेक्ट इन स्टडी हु रिसीव सम स्पेशल ट्रीटमेंट इन रिगार्ड टू द इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल. इन एन एक्सपेरिमेंट दिस ग्रुप is administered the independent variable, the variable that is manipulated to see its effect on other variable under study. Versus jo control group hota hai, control group is a comparison group. The independent variable is not administered on this group. Aur control group mein second point hum likh sakte hain, subjects in a study who do not receive the special treatment given to the experimental group. दूसरा difference आ सकता है chapter 2 में से between interview versus questionnaire. तो interview में हम क्या क्या लिख सकते हैं? Interview is a face-to-face interaction between two people. They can be structured or unstructured. Interviews are flexible. Questions can be added or altered. Interviewer जो होता है can dig deeper by posing counter questions and by noticing non-verbal clues. और इसमें लिख सकते हैं इंटरव्यू में, दे आर सब्जेक्टिव इन नेचर. इट इज नॉट गुड टूल फॉर दोज हु कांट एक्सप्रेस देमसेल्फ वर्बली. राइट, इट रिक्वायर्स हाईली स्किल्ड पर्सन एज इंटरव्यूअर. वर्सेस क्वेश्चनेयर में हम लिख सकते हैं, इट कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ अ फॉर्म कंटेनिंग अ सीरीज ऑफ क्वेश्चंस वेयर द रिस्पोंडेंट्स देमसेल्फ फिल इन द आंसर्स. क्वेश्चनेयर इज ऑलवेज स्ट्रक्चर्ड. इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू नो एनीथिंग मोर देन व्हाट इज आस्क्ड इन द क्वेश्चनेयर. दे आर हाईली ऑब्जेक्टिव. Sometimes someone else can also fill in the questionnaire other than the target person. Clarification of questions is sometimes not possible. They can be administered to a large number of people at a time. Comparatively, less skilled person can do the interpretation. Ab chapter 3 mein se differences dekh lete hain. Pehla difference aa sakta hai between enculturation versus socialization. To isme hum likh sakte hain ki it refers to all learning that occur in human life because of its availability in our social cultural context. Observation is the key element of enculturation. The contents are culturally shaped by our preceding generations. A major part of our behavior is the product of enculturation. Versus socialization, mein hum likh sakte hain, it is a process by which individuals acquire knowledge, skills and dispositions which enable them to participate as effective members of group and society. It is a process that continues over entire lifespan and through which one learns and develops ways of effective functioning at any stage of development. Socialization forms the basis of social and cultural transmission from one generation to the next. Next difference aa sakta hai between sensory nerve versus motor nerve. So sensory nerve mein hum likh sakte hain ki it is also called afferent nerves. They carry information from sense organs to central nervous system. The cell body of afferent nerve is located on the nerve root, which is outside the spinal cord. Versus motor nerves mein hum likh sakte hain ki motor nerve are also called efferent nerve. सेंसरी नर्व को हमने कहा था एफरेंट नर्व और मोटर नर्व को हम कह सकते हैं इफरेंट नर्व राइट जो मोटर नर्व्स होती हैं दैट इज इफरेंट नर्व्स दे कैरी इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम टू मसल्स और ग्लैंड्स अ मोटर नर्व कंडक्ट्स न्यूट्रल कमांड्स व्हिच डायरेक्ट कंट्रोल एंड रेगुलेट आवर मूवमेंट्स एंड अदर रिस्पॉन्सेज ओके नेक्स्ट डिफरेंस आ सकता है बिटवीन जीन्स वर्सेस मीन्स तो जीन्स में हम लिख सकते हैं जीन्स आर द कैरियर्स ऑफ हेरिडिटी It is the unit of hereditary information. These are short chromosome segments composed of DNA. Genes are blueprints for cell to reproduce and manufacture the proteins that maintain life. Okay? Aur memes mein hum likh sakte hain ki they are the DNA of human society, influencing every aspect of mind, behavior and culture. Genes write the script of biological transmissions versus jo memes hoti hain, they write the script of cultural transmissions. Okay, next difference aa sakta hai between society versus culture. Society is a group of people who occupy a particular territory and speak a common language not generally understood by neighboring people. Society may or may not be a single nation, but every society has its own culture. Versus culture mein hum likh sakte hain ki culture is a widely shared customs, beliefs, values, norms, institutions and other products of community that are transmitted socially across generations. Culture shapes human behavior from society to society. Culture is the label for all the different features that vary from society to society. Okay? फिर चैप्टर 4 में से कोई डिफरेंस नहीं है नेक्स्ट चैप्टर देखते हैं चैप्टर 5 में से डिफरेंस आ सकता है बिटवीन सेंसेशन वर्सेस परसेप्शन सेंसेशन इज क्वाइट अ सिंपलर मेंटल प्रोसेस देन द परसेप्शन सेंसेशन हेल्प्स इन गेटिंग एन एलिमेंट्री इंप्रेशन और अवेयरनेस ऑफ द प्रेशर ऑफ अ स्टिमुलस in one's environment without having any knowledge about its meaning and other interpretations. Sensation is the first step and initial process for getting desired knowledge about a stimulus. It is followed by perception. Sensation is possible without perception. अब perception के बारे में बात करें तो perception is more complex mental process in comparison to sensation. Sensation of an object or stimulus along with its proper meaning and interpretation is termed as perception. Perception needs sensation for its occurrence. As a follow-up step, it provides meaning to the outcomes of sensation. Perception is impossible without sensation. Okay? Next chapter देखते हैं chapter 6. इसमें पहला difference आ सकता है between generalization versus discrimination. Generalization में हम लिख सकते हैं कि Pavlov noticed that when a CR bond has been established by conditioning a stimulus which is similar to the CS can produce the same response and he called the stimulus generalization or in other words generalization occurs due to similarity. Example, if the dog is conditioned to salivate to tone, it will salivate to any type of tone. Stimulus generalization is conditioning happens usually more in childhood. Particularly when the child has not developed the capacity to differentiate between two stimuli. For example, during infancy, the baby considers every woman to be his mother, right? Versus discrimination में हम लिख सकते हैं कि discrimination is the process of learning to make one response to one stimulus and another response or no response to another stimulus. Example, discrimination can be obtained in classical conditioning by parenting one stimulus, the CS plus, with an unconditioned stimulus and never pairing another stimulus, the CS, with the unconditioned stimulus. दूसरा पॉइंट इसमें लिख सकते हैं कि डिस्क्रिमिनेशन इज अ रिस्पॉन्स ड्यू टू डिफरेंस इन अदर वर्ड्स. डिस्क्रिमिनेटिव रिस्पॉन्स डिपेंड्स ऑन द डिस्क्रिमिनेशन कैपेसिटी और डिस्क्रिमिनेशन लर्निंग ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म. ओके, नेक्स्ट डिफरेंस आ सकता है बिटवीन आर्टिफिशियल कॉन्सेप्ट वर्सेस नेचुरल कॉन्सेप्ट. तो आर्टिफिशियल कॉन्सेप्ट में पहला पॉइंट तो हम लिख सकते हैं कि आर्टिफिशियल कॉन्सेप्ट्स आर दोज दैट आर वेल डिफाइंड एंड रूल्स कनेक्टिंग द फीचर्स आर प्रिसाइज एंड रिजिड. These concepts are used in science and technologies. It is defined as set of features connected by some rules which are called relevant features. There may be some rule of which the conjunctive rule is often made. These concepts have features connected by a conjunctive rule. Example, a square, a triangle, etc. Versus natural concept में हम लिख सकते हैं कि natural concepts or categories are usually ill-defined. Numerous features are found in instances of a natural category. Example, biological objects or real-world products and human artifacts such as tools, clothes and houses. Natural categories are considered to be instances of one category under one condition and instances of another category under other condition. Example, jackfruit is a vegetable as well as a fruit. और नेचुरल कैटेगरीज में हम एक और पॉइंट लिख सकते हैं, दे हैव फैमिली रिजेम्बलेंस ऑल्सो. एग्जाम्पल, ऑल बर्ड्स हैव विंग्स, ले एग्स एंड पर्च ऑन ब्रांचेस ऑफ ट्रीज और टॉप्स ऑफ द टॉल स्ट्रक्चर्स. नेक्स्ट डिफरेंस आ सकता है बिटवीन जनरल ट्रांसफर वर्सेस स्पेसिफिक ट्रांसफर ऑफ लर्निंग. तो जनरल ट्रांसफर में हम लिख सकते हैं कि दिस लर्निंग प्रीडिस्पोजेस वन टू लर्न अनदर टास्क इन अ बेटर मैनर. द लर्निंग ऑफ वन टास्क वार्म अप द लर्नर टू लर्न द नेक्स्ट टास्क मोर कन्वीनियंटली. Warm-ups like limbering up the index finger and focusing the eye on some green object before pressing the trigger to hit the target, or the cricketer walks by jumping on one foot then on the other. After some time, warm-up effect disappears. While learning a task, a person not only learns the task but also develop a mental set for learning other tasks. Versus the specific transfer of learning hai. उसमें हम लिख सकते हैं कि whenever an organism learns something, it consists of a series of stimulus response associations. Specific transfer means the effect of learning task A on the learning of task B. The learning of A may make the learning of task B easier or more difficult or have no such effect. Such transfer depend on similarity, dissimilarity between the initial learning task and the second task. Okay. Next difference aa sakta hai between positive versus negative transfer of training and zero transfer of training. To positive transfer mein hum likh sakte hain ki in positive transfer of training, the earlier learning facilitates the current learning. Example, knowledge of physics facilitates the training in electronics. Knowledge of language facilitates the study of literature. Positive transfer of training occurs due to similarity of content, similar techniques and similar principles. Versus जो negative transfer है of training, उसमें हम लिख सकते हैं कि it is considered as negative transfer if new learning is retarded or made more tedious than the prior learning. It is also known as habit interference. इसमें हम example दे सकते हैं, when one learns to write by the left hand, after having a long practice with the right hand, the writing by the left hand is inhibited and delayed compared to a person who has learned to write by the left hand from the very beginning. Okay, और zero transfer में हम लिख सकते हैं कि it is also known as neutral transfer. When the acquisition of skill in one task neither facilitates nor inhibits learning in a subsequent tasks, it is zero transfer or no transfer. Okay, next difference आ सकता है between positive versus negative reinforcers and punishment. Positive reinforcer में हम लिख सकते हैं कि it involves stimuli that have pleasant consequences strengthen and maintain the responses that have caused them to occur. Positive reinforcers satisfy needs, example food, water, medals, praise, money, status, etc. Versus जो negative reinforcers होते हैं, stimuli that strengthen responses that permit the organism to avoid or escape their presence. Negative reinforcers involve unpleasant and painful stimuli. Negative reinforcement leads to learning of avoidance and escape response. Example, one learns to put on woolen clothes. Burn firewood or use electrical heater to avoid the unpleasant cold weather. One learns to move away from dangerous stimuli because they provide negative reinforcement. Punishment hota kya hai? A procedure by which the application or removal of stimulus decreases the strength of a behavior. Punishment decreases the likelihood that the response will occur again. Mild and delayed punishment has no effect. The stronger the punishment, the more lasting is the suppression effect, but it is not permanent. Example, timeout, scolding, spanking and the like can act as punishers. Next difference aa sakta hai between classical versus operant conditioning. Toh classical mein hum likh sakte hain, in classical conditioning, the responses are under the control of some stimulus. Aur hum isme kya likh sakte hain, in classical conditioning, US elicits responses, which is often called respondent conditioning. In this type of conditioning, the CS and US are well defined. In classical conditioning, the experimenter controls the occurrence of US. Thus, for US in classical conditioning, the organism remains passive. Example, in classical conditioning, the reinforcement occurs, that is US, in every trial. Classical conditioning is relatively simple and passive type of learning. Okay? Versus operant conditioning की अगर बात करें तो in this type responses are under the control of organism and are voluntary responses or operants. In operant conditioning, reinforcement is contingent upon a response. It depends upon a response. This response is emitted by the learner rather than elicited by the US. In this type, CS is not defined. It can be inferred but it is not directly known. In operant conditioning, the subject has to be active in order to be reinforced. Example, in operant conditioning, the reinforce occurs only when the organism makes the current responses. Operant conditioning is more complex type of learning. Next difference aa sakta hai between extinction versus spontaneous recovery. So extinction mein hum likh sakte hain ki it occurs when CS presented alone without the US for a number of trials. When this is done, the strength or magnitude of the CR gradually decreases. Second point isme hum likh sakte hain, if the pairing of CS, bell and CR saliva is not followed by the US food in classical conditioning or lever pressing is not followed by food pellets in the Skinner's box, the learned behavior will gradually become weak and disappear. Third point isme likh sakte hain, the key point in experimental extension is that if motivation is not periodically provided, the established responses seems to be extinguished. Versus jo spontaneous recovery hai, usme hum likh sakte hain ki Pavlov was of opinion that complete or permanent extinction of a CR is not possible. When the experimentally extinguished response reappear again after a period, it is called spontaneous recovery. Example, even without the presentation of food, bell produces a few drops of saliva. Second point is, the amount of spontaneous recovery depends on the duration of time lapsed after the extinction session. Third point is, the longer the duration of time lapsed, the greater is the recovery of learned response, such as recovery occurs spontaneously. Ab chapter 7 mein se differences dekhte hain. Pehla difference aa sakta hai between maintenance versus elaborative rehearsals. To maintenance mein hum likh sakte hain ki it is an important control process of STM. It is used to retain the information for as much time as required. As the name suggests, these kind of rehearsals simply maintain information through repetition, and when such repetitions discontinue, the information is lost. It is carried through silent or vocal repetition. Versus jo elaborative rehearsal hai, usme hum likh sakte hain ki from the STM, information enters the long-term memory through elaborative rehearsals. This rehearsal attempt to connect the to-be-retained information to the already existing information in the long-term memory. Isme example de sakte hain, the task of remembering the meaning of the work, humanity, will be easier if the meaning of the concepts such as compassion, truth and benevolence are already in place. Isme aur bhi hum likh sakte hain ki in elaborate rehearsals, one attempt to analyze the information in terms of various informations it arouses. It involves organization of the incoming information in as many ways as possible. Example, we can expand the information in some kind of logical framework, link it to similar memories, or else create a mental image. Next difference aa sakta hai between declarative versus procedural memories. So declarative mein hum likh sakte hain, all information pertaining to facts, names, dates, such as रिक्शा हैज थ्री व्हील्स और इंडिया बिकेम इंडिपेंडेंट ऑन 15 अगस्त 1947 और अ फ्रॉग इज एम्फीबियन और यू एंड योर फ्रेंड्स शेयर द सेम नेम आर पार्ट ऑफ दिस डिक्लेरेटिव. Facts retained in this memory are related to amenable to verbal descriptions. Procedural में हम लिख सकते हैं कि it refers to the memories relating to procedures of accomplishing various tasks, skill learnings, example how to make tea, play basketball or drive a car. Second point इसमें हम लिख सकते हैं कि contents of this memory cannot be described easily. Okay? Next difference आ सकता है between episodic versus semantic memory. तो episodic में हम लिख सकते हैं कि it contains biographical details of our life. वर्सेज जो सिमेंटिक होती है इट इज द मेमोरी ऑफ जनरल अवेयरनेस एंड नॉलेज. एपिसोडिक में हम लिख सकते हैं मेमोरीज रिलेटिंग टू आर पर्सनल लाइफ एक्सपीरियंसेस कॉन्स्टिट्यूट द एपिसोडिक मेमोरी एंड इट इज फॉर दिस रीजन दैट इट्स कंटेंट्स आर इमोशनल इन नेचर. वर्सेज जो सिमेंटिक मेमोरी होती है ऑल कंसेप्ट्स आइडियाज एंड रूल्स ऑफ लॉजिक्स आर स्टोर्ड इन सिमेंटिक मेमोरीज. थर्ड पॉइंट लिख सकते हैं एपिसोडिक में इट इंक्लूड्स मेमोरीज सच एज हाउ डिड यू फील व्हेन यू स्टूड फर्स्ट इन योर क्लास और हाउ एंग्री वॉज योर फ्रेंड एंड वॉट डिड शी से व्हेन यू डिड नॉट फुलफिल अ प्रोमिस. ओके और सिमेंटिक मेमोरी में हम लिख सकते हैं बिकॉज ऑफ सिमेंटिक मेमोरी वी रिमेंबर द मीनिंग ऑफ से नॉन वायलेंस और रिमेंबर दैट 2 + 6 = 8. राइट. एपिसोडिक में फोर्थ पॉइंट हम लिख सकते हैं कि सच एक्सपीरियंसेस आर हार्ड टू फॉरगेट येट इट इज True that many events take place continuously in our lives and that we do not remember all of them. Or semantic mein hum likh sakte hain ki unlike episodic memory, this kind of memory is not dated. We perhaps will not be able to tell when we learn the meaning of non-violence. Okay? Next chapter 8 mein dekhte hain. Isme pehla difference aa sakta hai between convergent versus divergent thinking in the context of creative thinking. So convergent thinking mein hum likh sakte hain ki it is a process through which many different starting points converge on the same solution to a problem. Or divergent mein hum likh sakte hain ki divergent thinking refers to the creation of many ideas as possible solution from one idea. The characteristics of divergent thinking is variable of thoughts involved. Convergent thinking jo hoti hai has one correct answer. Jabki divergent thinking mein it has many answers. Convergent thinking, it does not include fluency, flexibility and originality. Jabki divergent thinking includes fluency, flexibility and originality. Convergent thinking mein next point likh sakte hain, does not help in organization of ideas. Versus divergent thinking jo hoti hai, it leads to organization of new ideas. Next difference aa sakta hai between inductive reasoning versus deductive reasoning. Inductive reasoning is based on specific facts and observations versus jo deductive reasoning hoti hai, it begins with making general assumptions. Second point inductive reasoning mein hum likh sakte hain ki in this reasoning, people analyze other possible reasons and observe what the man is actually doing and then draw a conclusion. Aur deductive reasoning mein hum likh sakte hain ki in this reasoning, people make such mistakes in the sense that they assume but do not always know if the basic assumption is true. Okay? Ab chapter 9 ke differences dekhte hain. To sabse pehle difference aa sakta hai between biological motive versus psychological motive. Biological motive mein hum likh sakte hain ki they are guided mostly by the psychological mechanisms of body. Aur psychological motives mein hum likh sakte hain ki these are primarily learned from the individual's interaction with the various environmental factors. Biological mein hum likh sakte hain focus on innate biological causes of motivation like hormones, neurotransmitters, brain structures versus jo psychological motive hai usme hum likh sakte hain they focus on the factors jaise ki social and environmental and how they interact with each other to produce motivation. Third point biological motive mein hum likh sakte hain ki concerned with the functions performed by various body parts such as hypothalamus, limbic system etc. Aur psychological motive mein hum likh sakte hain ki they are not concerned with functions of various parts of the body. Fir biological mein hum example de sakte hain jaise ki hunger, thirst etc. Aur psychological mein hum likh sakte hain need for power, achievement, affiliation etc. Okay? Next difference aa sakta hai between trait anxiety versus state anxiety. So trait anxiety mein hum likh sakte hain ki it is viewed as a relatively enduring disposition to be anxious in many different situations. It represents the degree to which people vary in the degree of anxiety proneness. Versus jo state anxiety hai is the anxiety an individual experiences in a specific situation at a specific time. It is characterized by feelings of tension, nervousness and worry. Okay? Next difference aa sakta hai between achievement versus affiliation versus power motive. So achievement motive mein to hum likh sakte hain ki it refers to the desire of a person to meet standards of excellence. It is not biological but has tremendous effects on human behavior. People differ in degree to which they experience this need. Okay. Next, affiliation motive में हम लिख सकते हैं, groups constitute an important feature of human life. Affiliation or relating with others is major part of our life. It involves motivation for social conduct. There are four different aspects of interpersonal contact that serve as potential sources of gratification. वो कौन से चार different aspects हैं? पहला है positive stimulation, the ability of affiliation to provide enjoyable, affective and cognitive stimulation. Second है attention, the potential for enhancement of feeling of self-worth and importance through praise and the focusing of others' attention on oneself. Third है social companion, the capacity for reduction of ambiguity through the acquisition of self-relevant information. और fourth हम लिख सकते हैं emotional support or sympathy. अब करते हैं बात power motive के बारे में. Power motive refers to the desire to be in charge, to have status and prestige and influence others. It is also related to competitiveness and aggression. One of the important characteristics of power motivated people is that they are assertive. Okay, so isi question ke saath ye video yahi pe samapt hoti hai.